Now the next topic is the performance analysis of a transmission line. So when I need to find out about the performance of something, that is generally on the basis of the efficiency of that particular transmission line. And the major role of a transmission line is to transmit or send the power from one end to the other. So basically the efficiency of the transmission line would be the ratio of the output power to the input power. And the active power is the one which we actually count. So that is why the output power is something that you receive on the receiving end. So VR, IR multiplied by cos phi R, that is power factor at the receiving end, divided by the product of the sending end voltage, sending end current, and the power factor at the sending end. So this is what you can say. And basically the cos. And the receiving end, like the cos, the power factor, there's one more thing, that is the cos phi r, that is the receiving end power factor. Basically, it depends on load connected. And where is generally the load connected? Generally at the receiving end. So you can consider this. And one more thing, that is the phi s, that is the sending end angle between the voltage and the current, that is the sending end voltage and the sending end current, that varies with the receiving end angle between the receiving end voltage and the receiving end current. So this is one of the performance analysis factors for the transmission line, that is the efficiency of the transmission. So now we know that efficiency of transmission is one of the factor which determines how good or bad your transmission line is behaving right now. So efficiency of transmission line. And another major important factor, that is the voltage regulation. So a voltage regulation I've come across several times, and this is a very important topic, and this is going to like help you in power system as well as basic electrical engineering as well. And even in electrical machines, when you are studying about transformers, there also voltage regulation like topic, it arises there also. So generally you might have learned this very well, that is like say for example, this is the sending end voltage and the sending end current, so that is Vs and Is. Now this is your transmission line, and now this is your receiving end voltage and the receiving end current. And since you have the parameters of transmission line, that is resistance, inductance and capacitance, what happens is that all of these factors, they create nothing but a voltage drop in the transmission line. And since a voltage drop takes place, the voltage drops are what? First is VR. VR is given by I multiplied by R. Another one is known as the voltage drop across the inductance, that is will be I multiplied by XL, and VC would be equal to I multiplied by XC. So these are the three voltage drops which may take place because of which, and R is the resistance, XL is given by omega L, and XC is given by 1 upon omega C. So these are nothing but the reactances. So if it is XL, then that is inductive reactance, XC is the capacitive reactance. So now we know very well that whenever the current is flowing through any transmission line, then because of the product of current and resistance, current and inductive reactance, current and capacitive reactance, voltage drop overall takes place. So that is why what we can say, that the receiving end voltage is generally less than the sending end voltage. One repeat, the voltage drop, that is the difference between sending and receiving end voltages, expressed as a percentage of the receiving end voltage, is known as the voltage regulation. So this is the basic definition of voltage regulation. That is again very easy. Okay. So now there is one more definition that comes at this point of time, and that is the formal definition for the voltage regulation. So this is the formal definition of your voltage regulation. So the formal definition says that voltage regulation is defined as the change in voltage. Again, the change in voltage is nothing but the difference in the sending and the receiving end voltages, that is Vs minus Vr, okay, at the receiving end, at the receiving end, when full load is thrown off, keeping sending end voltage and the frequency unchanged. So these are certain conditions for the voltage regulation, that is full load is thrown off, and secondly that the voltage at the sending end and the frequency, they remain unchanged. So coming to the formula, so you have voltage regulation is nothing but Vs minus Vr upon Vr multiplied by 100. Now whenever you are increasing the load, so when the load is increased, so in that case the current which is flowing will also going to be increased, and when the current is increased, so that is why the voltage drops are going to increase. And when the voltage drops are going to increase, in that case the difference between Vs minus Vr, that particular difference is also going to increase. And when this numerator is increasing with respect to the denominator, as you know that the receiving end is further decreasing voltage. Why? Because since the voltage drops are increasing, that is why the receiving end voltage is also going to reduce. And Vs minus Vr, that is the difference in the sending and the receiving end voltages, that difference is keeping on increasing. So ultimately what you can say that the voltage regulation increases with increase in the load. So this is one important point that you need to keep in mind. Second important point that you need to keep in mind, that is ideally what you require, that voltage at the sending end is equal to the voltage at the receiving end. Okay, you also want that even on increase of current, okay, voltage drops should remain zero. If the voltage drop is going to remain zero, in that case the sending end voltage would be equal to the receiving end voltage. Now substituting the value of Vr to be equal to Vs, so Vs minus Vs would be equal to nothing but zero. So ideally the value of voltage regulation is equal to zero. But as you know very well, that something that is ideal is definitely not practical. So this cannot exist practically, and in fact not even anywhere, because you know very well that efficiency of any system is definitely not 100%. So similarly the voltage drops are going to exist, and with the increase in load definitely the difference between the sending and the receiving end voltages are going to increase, and that is why the voltage regulation is also going to increase with the increase in load. And third most important point is that we cannot vary the load current to be reduced. That is, we cannot reduce the value of the load current. Why? Because that load current is totally dependent on the consumers. So you cannot maintain, or you cannot vary, or you cannot actually determine what is going to be the amount of load that is coming from the consumer end. So that is why you definitely cannot control the load current. And since you cannot control the load current, that is why we can say that definitely in order to optimize the transmission line, a major important thing, that is to optimize a transmission line you have to vary the resistance, inductance and capacitance parameters. So that is all about the voltage regulation. I just hope that it is clear to you.